on the same day, so I just can get it all one day. But I want to split it up into two parts, like I said in the last video, to it's just not me sitting here and talking for 20, 30 minutes. But so I'm gonna get back to the story just right now. Make sure you like and subscribe, comment down below. But so let's get back to the story. Tyler drives off. Like I said, if you watch the last one, Tyler drives off after the owner tells us we can't stay anymore, and he tells us we have to leave. So we drive off. One of our friends calls us up, is like, bro, let's talk about this. Like, what's that? What we want to do? Like, this and that. And so we ended up meeting, like, at a cul-de-sac little neighborhood. And it was, like, all of us, 12 of us, sitting there, like, what should we do? Like, we don't want to go home after this. Like, this is stupid. Like, we all wanted to stay and have fun. But, like, the thing was, we got scammed $130 each. So, like, it's not like we had more money to go blow and stuff. So our main goal was to get the money back. So Tyler was like on the phone with the bank while the other half of us were deciding what we should do. So Tyler was on the phone for like 45 minutes, maybe. I don't even know how long he was on the phone, but I know it was a long time. And he was on the phone talking to the bank. And so we actually got really lucky, and the bank gave Tyler the money back, and they're going to do an investigation with this. So they gave him the $1,200, whatever it was. And so, but it's gonna take up to 10 business days, and then like in 90 days they're gonna do the investigation, and in 90 days they're gonna stop the investigation, hopefully have it done. But so we ended up getting our money back. That's a good thing. So we were all happy about having our money back. Like, we were sad about the Airbnb, but we were happy that the money was like back, can come back to us, because we were all mad at that. Like, literally everyone's on the phone with their parents and talking, and like, we did not know, and because we don't want to go spend more money. But so we got our money back, and then let's see what happened after that. So we were deciding, and then we were like, cause no one wanted to go home, like I said. But so we were like, bro, let's just get a hotel for the night, and then like have some fun, like as much fun as we can, go walking through downtown. Let's go to San Diego, go walking through downtown and have some fun. So we all decided, let's go to downtown, get a hotel right around downtown, and split it up to like three rooms or something. So we ended up going to downtown San Diego, 45 minutes more the down, and we ended up getting three rooms at this nice hotel right in downtown. And it was like not that expensive. Like, we ended up saving money in the long haul because it was cheaper. So we ended up three rooms, and so there's two per bed because everyone's couples in my group. So that ended up being fun. Hotel, we got settled in, everyone paid the money, we parked our cars, we were like, let's relax for a little bit because we've had a horrible past couple hours because everyone was still kind of mad. But we ended up getting a hotel, so everyone's kind of happy. So listen to this, guys. So we got a hotel. So then half of them go up to the rooms, and the other half of us are getting stuff, and we go into the room, and we get into the elevator, and then we like clicking the button, and it wasn't working. And we're like, what is happening? This is funny. And we're like, what is happening? So we went to another elevator, and then that didn't work also. We went to another elevator, and I was like, it's for employees only. So we couldn't go on that one. So then we went back to the other elevator, and it wasn't working. This worker came by and was like, what's going on? But we ended up taking the stairs, up four floors of stairs. And that was so steep, bro. And then we get to the fourth floor, and we're dying. And then the worker comes up, and he's like, the elevator works fine. You just have to put your room key into there. And we're like, are you kidding me? That's all we had to do? We walked four flights of stairs, and all we had to do was put our room key to the elevator, and it would have worked. But that's funny. So we settled in, we're like, okay, let's go eat. We're all starving. Let's go walk downtown and blah, blah. So we walk in downtown, having some fun, and I see Padres Stadium. Love Padres Stadium. Walking downtown, can't decide what we want to eat. Everyone's hungry. We just couldn't make a decision. So we ended up making a big circle, and then we're like, we found a spaghetti factory, and spaghetti factory, we're like, oh, that sounds schmack. Let's go to spaghetti factory. So we went to spaghetti factory, and then put our name down, and then half of us went to go take a shot somewhere, and because we were at a bad day, and then the other half of the group went and like just sat down somewhere. So we're taking we're about to get our shot, and we see our friends like waving at something. We see our other friend throwing up something in the air, like right next to the restaurant. The workers in the restaurant that we were at were getting mad because our friend was literally outside throwing something up. We're like, what is she doing? So then we're like, we called one of our friends, like, dude, tell her to stop. Like, their workers are about to get pissed at her, like, blah, blah. So then I come out, we get our shot, I come out, and I'm like, dude, what was happening? And then, so there was this random guy in a building, like in the middle of a building. He had a room and his window was open. And he was like throwing, he was like weird guy. He was throwing stuff out his window, like to us, to my friends. And they were trying to get it, and something got stuck in a tree. And my friend was throwing her thing up in the air, trying to knock it out of the tree, but it wasn't working. And so that's why they ended up, were waving at someone, talking to someone. This guy was literally throwing like boxes, like. He was like a crackhead, I think, but I'm not sure. But I didn't see it. But like all that's happening, and then we're like, what the heck? And then like supposedly before that, some old lady came up to them and was like, you guys have good vibes, and like just talking positivity to us. And we're like, okay, this tastes getting better. So we end up going to Spaghetti Factory after a long wait, and then we have to walk with our mask in. This is why I find that's dumb. So you walk in with a mask; it's required. But right when you get to your table and sit down, they're like, oh, you can take your mask off. We're like, okay, what's the point of walking in with a mask if I'm just gonna take it off? But we ended up walking to the Spaghetti Factory. Ate. We got put to two separate tables because there's too many of us.
There was like two water bottles, like some other shit.
And then that was a cool dinner. We had some fun. Sang my girlfriend and Landon happy birthday because their birthday's coming up. And so then that happens, and then after dinner, we walk more downtown, and so we're talking about like what we're gonna do and just partying. We're just like, oh, let's just party in our rooms, this and that. So then everyone's talking about like, oh, like no one better go to sleep. Some people were tired and want to go to sleep. They're like, no, don't go to sleep. And like me and my girlfriend and the Tyler Ashley straight room, we're like, oh, we'll probably fall asleep early, like this and that. So we're partying, and we find out like everyone ends up falling asleep pretty early, and like me, Tyler, Ashley, and my girlfriend were all like still up, and it was like 1 in the morning. And then we had two other friends with us, and we were literally like the last ones up. And we were like, wow, we were the last ones up. But so we ended up like getting like, we had fun. You know, you probably guys know what we were doing in the hotel room. Getting fun, yes. And so we were singing karaoke, put on YouTube, put on karaoke, and we were literally singing, jumping, this and that. We were like, it was lit. I'll tell you guys that. It was fun. And so then, like 1:30 a.m. hits around, we get a knock on the door, and I'm like, oh crap. It's 1:30 comes, and I look in the people and I see a worker, and I'm like, guys, it's a worker. And they're like, open it. And I was like, fuck. So I opened it, and it was a worker, and he was like, hey, I'm getting noise complaint from you guys. Like, you guys need to like quiet down a little bit. And like, he was like, this is your guys' first and last warning. If I give you another warning, you're kicking out. And we're like, okay. So after that, it was like, we're like, okay, it's late, like let's just go to sleep. Like everyone else had a good time in their other rooms, and we had a good time in our room. So we honestly, like, it was still fun. Like we went to a hotel and got a nice hotel, and we still kind of all had fun. But like, it was just like the Airbnb would have been better. Like, we know, like, oh, we would not got a noise complaint. Like, oh, we could have all been together in one big house. Like, so that happened. And then, but we made the best of what we could have like made out of it. Like, at least we all just didn't go home and give up, and like went home and just all like cried ourselves to sleep. Like, I don't know, but like at least we went out and did something. Like, I was just happy about that. Like, even though we had I've never had this crappy of a day in my life, guys. Like, I was literally mind blown of what happened. I was like, well, how could all this have happened to us? Like, nothing was going right this day for us. So we ended up going to sleep. Everyone woke up the next morning and was like, okay, let's go to brunch, and let's go to the beach, and then we'll all go to my house because I have a pool and jacuzzi, and we'll all go swimming and go in the jacuzzi and get like Trent at my house. And then we were like, okay, that was down. So we all went to brunch, and we're going to this brunch place, and this place is packed that we were going to. Okay, we're like, nah, let's go somewhere else. So we're walking and trying to find somewhere to eat, and we find up on this cool spot. We see bowling like lanes, and we're like, what? So we end up going to this cool restaurant with bowling, like you can eat and bowl. And it was like, and their food was so bomb. Literally the best food ever. And we ended up bowling, having a blast. And so we were like, whoever, we were just walking and saw this place and we're like, wow, good come up on this place. We had a fun ass time. So then after that, Landy and his girl, Megan, and I think that's it. They went home because they had to do something. And then the rest of us went to the beach. And then we all went to the beach. It was fun as heck. I'll drop a couple clips for you probably in this video because I took a couple clips of the beach. And we went, the water was cold, but it was so fun. It was packed though. And I saw a cop arguing with someone about racism. So that was, I was like, wow. But we ended up only staying, I was like staying there for a couple hours, but all my friends are white and they all got burning or hot. I'm a Mexican, I can deal with the sun, but they all got burning hot. And we literally ended up staying there for like hour and a half maybe. And everyone's like, okay, let's go home and go to Miguel's house. And I was like, okay, I guess. I wanted to stay at the beach more, but everyone wanted to go home. So tired, super tired. And my friend Tyler was like, hey Miguel, can you drive home? I'm super tired, like this and that. Like, I'm sunburned, this and that. So I was like, okay, I'll drive home. So then I'm going to drop a clip also right here of them all asleep. So then I literally drove home an hour and a half because we were deep in San Diego. So I drove home and we all went home, went to my house. We got some Chick-fil-A and we went swimming, went in jacuzzi, and we were all talking, just chilling, bro, having a good time. But, and that's pretty much the end of the story. And it's not as good as the first part, but we had a wild weekend, guys. Like, we were supposed to get turned this weekend and have some fun at the Airbnb and get, like I said, this place was supposed to go down this weekend in history books, but it did, like, it didn't go our way. Got scammed of $1,200. But yeah, that was my crazy weekend. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below what you think of this whole story. Please make sure you like and subscribe. I'm begging you. And like I said, we made the best out of it. I was happy with this weekend. I got to play my Sunday league game still, even because I wasn't supposed to go because I was supposed to be gone on weekend. So I still got to do what I want to do on Sunday. And but we had fun. Like, it will still go down in the history books of what happened this weekend. It just wasn't supposed to be like this. It was supposed to be fun. But so go down to history books, like I said. So I hope you all enjoyed. Make sure y'all like, subscribe. I know I said it a lot, but I truly mean it. If you stick through this whole video and want to listen to this whole story. So I hope you all have a wonderful day and have a blessed day and stay safe out there, okay? Deuces.